be awesome, man.
Yeah, no doubt.
All right, good morning, fellow adventurers. We're back out for another weekend here. Look who I ran into.
Just randomly ran into each other out here in the woods.
Total surprise. No, kidding. Now, up here with Hillbilly and beautiful Sarah here. We're going to be heading out to the, or actually we are at the Dolly Sods Wilderness in West Virginia. It is a brisk 38 degrees right now and very windy. We're looking for a pretty wintry, fallish type of weekend here. But it's going to be an awesome weekend. Hillbilly's plotted out a nice little route for us that's going to hit all the highlights of Dolly Sods. I'll tell you more about the sods later. But right now we're going to start walking because it's freaking cold. We'll see ya. So we're starting out at the Bear Rocks trailhead. I think that's what it is, right?
Yep.
Bear Rocks. We got about just 10 miles today to do and under 10 miles tomorrow. Total of about 20 miles. Gonna be a loop. And we're gonna camp up at a place called Lion's Head, big outcropping, one of the higher points in the sods. It's supposed to have a great view. Looking forward to it. So let's get it on, brother.
Let's go.
I can't even talk. My lips are so cold.
All the blueberries turn red.
Beautiful. Damn it, Eddie. There's more rocks.
Come on,
I hate the rocks.
I'll tell you, that lasts like good a number on these, man, with toes starting to peel off.
Alright, so this is kind of our first intersection here. We're going to be continuing down the Bear Rocks Trail. But the intersecting trail here is the Dobbin Grade. We're coming back this way. And there's a reason we're saving that trail for the end. Just wait till you see it. Yeah, and Dolly Sods is a beautiful place. You saw the near alpine tundra that we came in on. And we've got these lower, you come down just a little bit of elevation, you've got these little lowland spruce forests. Got some birch or aspen in here mixed in as well. Maybe not aspen, I can't tell from this distance, but. And then you got these lower meadows as well. It's such a diverse environment, which is what makes it really interesting. It sort of creates its own weather too. So the weather's really unpredictable. There's not supposed to be any rain this weekend, but it is supposed to be cold. Check this out. A little walkway here. Probably need it. This is all marshy in here. Waterlogged. That's where they get the sods part of the name. First part, the Dolly, originates from the family that used to be established this area up here, the Dollies, D-A-H-L-E, I think is how it was spelled, back in the 1800s. So, Dolly Sods. Alright, a little water crossing here.
Right fork of Red Creek.
The right fork of Red Creek.
All the
And some campers over here. Very cool. Man, a lot of people out here camping. Alright, I'm gonna see if I can film while I'm doing this. It's probably gonna be a bad mistake, but we'll see what happens. A little bit of elevation change here, not too bad. This is the part that hikers never show. Had to stop and take some clothing off. Getting a little warm, but here's another one of those transitions I was telling you about. Coming from the forest back up into the tundra again. Or whatever it's called. Karen? This is about a 5.5 hour drive from my house, but I'm really glad I came. Well worth it. I just can't put the camera away. Look at this. Only thing that would make this better is if the sun was out today. And it may be later, but this morning these clouds have rolled in. But just so much color up here. Now all these maroon colored plants you see here are huckleberry. And they're everywhere. I don't think it's probably hit, but maybe 40, 42 degrees. And this wind is pretty brutal, coming right directly at us. So we're gonna eat. We're gonna be getting up into the trees here in a little bit, so hopefully the wind will die down. Ooh. Got some big ones up here. Oh yeah, look at that. All right, I'll check back with you guys later. Come on, son. I'm rooting for you. All right. Little intersection here. So Bear Rocks is what we just came on. The Raven Ridge we're picking up right now comes in from that direction. And we're taking it up here more, a little bit more elevation gain on the open. I mean, I'll tell you what, there's a lot of signs of wildlife up here. I've seen a lot of deer. what I believe is some coyote or dog, but more likely it's coyote. And a lot of bear scat. Been sitting right on the trail all the way up here. It's like they're taunting us. Hopefully Hillbilly's not a magnet like he was up in Pennsylvania, New Jersey. Because he had a week-long trip up here and he had 8 or 10 bears he encountered. One of them wouldn't leave him alone. So maybe I'll just camp a little farther away from him tonight. Alright, intersection with Beaver View Trail, number 523 ahead. Staying on the Raven Ridge.
See the cars up at Bear Rocks?
Huh? Oh, wow. Yeah, I can see
the light reflecting off of it.
Yeah, a little glint of metal window reflection way out there. That's where we left from. Bear Rocks.
See the space right here.
So, oh geez, is that all our cars up there?
Yeah.
Probably a good 2+ miles at this point.
Anytime you run into a patch of spruce up here like this, there's almost always camping up in it.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, there's fire engines back there.
Little copse of spruces. These are everywhere up here, so we'll be probably camping in something like this tonight. They're perfect. And you actually almost need it because there's way too much wind up here. Oh, gotta go. Had to go around the mud hole. So the direction we're headed, at least for a stop on our way, is going to be up there at those rocks. We're going to ride the ridge all the way around.
They don't do anything to mitigate it because, you know, it's natural. The beavers build dams wherever they build them.
All right, I'm doing it.
This section's looking almost appropriate for Halloween. Dark and gloomy. Nice soft pine needle covered floor here. Easy to walk on. I'm liking it. Yeah, I can walk on this all day. Okay, another junction we've hit. Beaver View Trail, that direction. Bear Rocks Trail. We were riding the Raven Ridge Trail. And we're now going to turn onto the Rocky Ridge this direction. So we're going to ride this ridge for a while. And Hillbilly tells me this is the highest elevation plateau east of the Mississippi. So we're up close to 5,000. We're not quite there. I think it's like 48, 47, 48, something like that.
Ooh, I finally got the hair on my face for a second.
Thank you. How you doing?
Where the prevailing winds always hit this side. Gap or crack in the rock over here.
Oh wow.
Check this one out
right
here.
That's pretty cool.
It is an adventure to squeeze your ass through there.
Think we can make it?
Maybe you can.
I dude it.
Tear my puppy to shreds. I don't know, my belly's getting a little bigger. I don't know if I squeezed through it or not.
I dude it. I dude it.
You're still right there. All these rocks up here are pretty much sandstone, so the wind is really eroding them away. That's why they're kind
of
shaped
as
they are. And, a lot of sand on the ground on the trail because of it.
No, I just like the asshole sand.
Yeah. Alright. We've been riding this ridge for a while. Oh. I got a dog. Anyway, it's overshadowed by these huge sandstone formations, man, incredible. Look at this. Wow.
Fucked up because that looks like an actual trail, but it's not. This is the actual trail.
The part that doesn't look like a trail?
Yeah.
This is the actual trail?
I was telling them the first time I ever came here, I took this wrong turn right here and ended up about a half a mile off trail.
Oh, man.
Pulled out Gaia to finally realize that I wasn't anywhere near trail. Backtracked back to here.
Vantage points just never stop up here. Beautiful valley. A lake down here. Kind of a populated area down there. But from what Hillbilly tells me, a lot of it is wildlife refuge, marshy land. Intersection with the Harmon Trail. This makes a run across the sods to something on the other side. We're staying on the rocky ridge down this way. I didn't mention earlier, this week is peak leaf season for this area. Definitely holds true. These colors are popping. Alright, we're just coming off of Blackbird Knob Trail and turning onto Big Stone Coal Trail. Number 513.
Don't go that way.
Have a good hike. So we're right here. And we are going down this way. Do you breathe the mountain?
Breast
mountain. That's what the line set is right there, that outcropping, right?
It's down from the summit a little bit.
Okay. Cool. I've never seen this particular forest map before. And lays it out nice on Cal Topo. It's not as nice.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's where we came from.
Way down under here. So we've done this top corner, basically.
Well, come on, let's get a move on. We're behind.
Yeah. Just to talk about it, be about it.
Alright, so once again we've changed biomes. Got a huge pine forest here to my left. Just when you think you've seen it all up here, it changes on you again and you see something new. A lot of ferns laying around here. Sort of has that Pacific Northwest feel with all the moss on the down logs and everything. Alright, so we're at the last water crossing right before we start climbing up to Lion's Head. We're going to camel up here, water up, fill up all of our containers because it's a dry camp, and we'll be on our way to camp. So we just stopped off with some really beautiful falls here. About a mile away from our camp, just past our watering source. We made some nice little pool down there. All right, continuing on.
Keep on
stepping. So this last stretch up to the Lion's Head area is pretty much a rock scramble. Check this out. A lot of rocks. Now see, I'm gonna have to edit that out now.
Please tell me you've been capturing some of her rapping.
Oh, I just did now.
Oh, they did have some rather body stuff back then.
Salt and pepper tea.
Yeah, so we gotta go up there to get to Lion's Head. Supposedly it's a brief climb, but man, that's steep. They're still climbing. I'm gonna wait here and see if they pass out before they get to the top. Just kidding, it's not gonna be that bad. But I'm looking forward to camp, so I'm gonna move. I'll see you at the top. All right, folks, we finally got into camp and set up. Did a firewood harvest from the surrounding woods, and we did actually have a fire going. But we're all settled in, ready for dinner and some rest tonight. But we're gonna go take a little walk here to Lion's Head. It's just about a 5-minute walk. So fire looks like it's good. That's under control. Not any flames, just a few embers right there. It's in a fire pit, and there's other people around anyway. So we're gonna go ahead and head down here and check out Lion's Head. Wow.
Right?
All right, I'll give you this one, Hillbilly. Good job. Another set of cliffs on that opposing mountain over there.
We're standing on Lion's Head right now.
A little bit of a drop.
You're standing on Lion's Head right now.
This is Lion's Head.
The only way to see it, you gotta go over there and you look back at it and you could see the Lion's Head you're standing on.
Cool. And down that way, it looks like a little eagle's beak or something.
Kind of does, yeah. The scramble takes you back around this back side, down and around a bunch of these really, really nice overlook points.
And it's good to do it on a backpack. It's okay to do it with a backpack on?
Oh, absolutely. Okay. Yeah, I've done it several times. It's Roarball Cliffs right across the valley.
What are they called?
Roarball.
Roarball.
Roarball Trail passes right through all of that. Below us is Red Creek.
Yeah. If you ever have the ability and the means, get up here to check out Lion's Head.
All over there, that's all rolling plains. This kind of flat peak up here,
yep,
it's called Mountport Crayon. It's one of the tallest, I think like the 7th or 8th tallest peak in West Virginia, but it's supposed to be the most wild and the most inaccessible peak in West Virginia. It's like 4,700 and some change, no trails that go to the top.
Wow.
Very harsh weather.
Well, I'm gonna go see if I can find the Lion's Head. I will tell you, it is not for the faint of heart. The There are some pretty good gaps that you got to jump over. But oh yeah, I do see the resemblance a little bit there. Right over here, lion. My shadow is. Hello. Very cool. I like it. I was just looking at this one over here. Looks like a little eagle's beak. Hey, maybe I'm onto something. I can name it. Yeah, I can't say enough about this. This is so incredible. And then another overlook on this side, looking down a different part of the valley. So I guess we're going to be heading down. Where's the scramble at?
On that side? Right over here and kind of down. What okay. We're looking at right now, there's a bit of a kind of a place you can sit down and lower yourself to get down here.
Okay.
Come around this bottom and then over to some really good views over that way.
And head that way towards the next turn off on the trail. Very good example of this subalpine environment that is everywhere up here. Not much can grow up here except for the hardy stuff that's used to that type of weather. The trees don't get very big, and a lot of them are flagged. You can tell kind of like which way the prevailing winds are coming, which is this way, because the left side of the trees are more bare. And actually right now, that's definitely where the winds are coming from. All right, everybody. We are settling the camp. Everybody's either has eaten or is currently in the process of eating. We got a nice fire going there. Hillbilly's got some country music going, so life's pretty good right now, other than the cool breeze. But it's all good, it's part of the experience. Filming this on my phone right now because my GoPro keeps shutting down on me. I think it's too cold. But we did 10 and a half miles today. Going to be doing about probably just under 10 tomorrow. Not really in any rush. I'm going to stay another night in the hotel when we get out of here, so I don't really need to rush out. But yeah, the last part of the trail is going to be about a mile or so on what's called the Dobbin Grade, and it's going to be an interesting one. Not going to reveal what it's all about yet, but we saved that trail for last for a reason. I think I mentioned that to you earlier. Gonna be fun. But yeah, the sky has actually cleared up. So it's looking good for my little astrophotography session I wanted to have tonight. And again, that really depends on if it's cold, very, very cold. I may not be able to get the camera to stay on. So we'll see about that. But I should get some pretty good shots out here of the stars. Again, that remains to be seen. All right, I'll check in with you later.